Shapes and Select Sound. And what made it fold over was he started letting me talk on them tapes. Yeah. When he started letting me talk on them tapes, and I started shouting out, I had just came from college. See, like, people don't even know, like, East Texas is what blew up Slow Down Music, because I started shouting out Marshall, Tyler, Longview. Then all these stores started opening up and acquisition, and everybody would just take a little trips around the circle and come back home.
So why were you shouting out East Texas spots? You say you were familiar?
Well, I'm going to tell you something uniquely. Now, East Texas, I went to school in Marshall, Texas, Wiley College. So my homeboy Choke had a store up there called Sound City. So when I came back home and got with Watts in 94, I started trying to send some tape back up there, but they never would move. So I said, man, when Watts started letting me talk on the tapes, I started shouting my college out. And I started shouting out his record store and the city. And from there, it just went. Then I started finding stores. Then I started shouting out the city. Like, we weren't even in the cities yet. I was just shouting out the city surrounding. What's up, Longview? What's up, Tyler? Then the people started calling from Tyler. Hey, man, people keep coming in asking for some tapes, man. And then I did my homeboy. That's how we got in L.A. My homeboy used to own Vision's Records and Tapes off of Crenshaw Boulevard in L.A. I used to shout him out for 5 years, man. Every time on all them tapes, just shout him out. Then he finally called me and said, man, you got to go on and send me some tapes, man. People keep coming in asking for the tapes. So it was just the work, man, started shouting out. I ain't even never know. It's just like Japan, Europe, everybody. I ain't never been nowhere. I just started shouting people out. Once I realized it was working, I was like, man, wherever you at, no matter where you at, Japan, whatever, what's up, y'all go get them tapes.
But you know what, though, man? How many people were stationed in the military taking those tapes?
That's what was going on. That's what, once I figured out they was going to the military, man, because we had these one dudes at I-10 Music in San Diego. They was on that base. Boy, they used to buy the hell out them tapes. And, man, and then there was another, some dudes in Virginia that was selling some tapes, too. I forgot the name of their store. Sean, when I started realizing that, and then we finally got one letter to the record shop to select the sound. We got our first letter from Japan. Dude was like, man, we jam y'all in Japan. They wrote a letter to the record store saying, we jam y'all in Japan. They bootlegging this and that, yeah. Off the military base, yeah.
Man, those shout outs, bro, that was like genius. That was genius because at that time the store list was the most valuable thing you could have. You know, your distribution network, and you
don't even understand. We created that distribution, man. You don't even understand what we created. That's why I shouted it out, man.
Hey, man. From an economic standpoint, that shit was powerful. And it's a shame that a lot of those stores aren't open no more, and that aspect of the game is gone. Like right now with everything that's happening and the lockdown and you can't do shows and all that, I wish all them stores were still open. That would be like, I mean, I'm sure it'd be a blessing for them too. Like I would just
yeah.
Some of that stuff, man.